In the previous video, we discussed classification of bone according to position in the skeleton, according to structure, and according to ossification. Now we will discuss classification of bone according to the shape. Shape of bone, this shape, long bone. The long bone present mainly in the limbs. In the upper limb, humerus, radius, ulna, femur, tibia, fibula, all these are long bones in the limbs. The long bones in the limbs consists of two ends called epiphyses. Upper epiphyses and lower epiphyses. What is meant by physis? Physis is the growing plate. This cartilage, which is responsible for growth in length of the bone, is called physis. And this part of the bone is just above the physis. Just above means epi. Therefore, it is called epiphysis. Upper femoral epiphysis, this is the femur. Therefore, this is the upper epiphysis and this is the lower epiphysis. Two ends. In between the two ends, in between the two epiphyses, there is a shaft. The shaft is called diaphysis. Therefore, the long bone is formed of two ends, epiphyses, and in between the two epiphyses, there is a shaft or diaphysis. First of all, we will discuss the epiphyses. What's the epiphyses? It is the expanded end. The expanded upper and the expanded lower end of the long bone. It is articular, covered by articular cartilage, because the ends of the bone articulate with the other bones to form joints. The end is covered by articular cartilage, which is a type of cartilage called hyaline cartilage. In between the two epiphyses, there is the center of the shaft, is called diaphysis. The diaphysis is the tubular bone, like a tube, with outer part of bone called the cortex, and in the center there is a cavity called the medullary cavity. This cavity is lined by endosteum, a layer called endosteum. Endo means inside or lining. Therefore, this bone and this cavity is lined by endosteum, which containing the bone marrow. The bone marrow is actually not a bone. It is a soft vascular tissue. The medullary cavity, this cavity which is called medullary cavity, does not extend to the ends of the bone. The medullary cavities does not extend to the ends of the bone, to the area which is called the metaphysis, and does not extend to the epiphysis. The outer surface of the bone is covered by a fibrocellular sheath. Fibrocellular sheath called periosteum around the bone. Layer around the bone, surround the bone, therefore it's called periosteum. Osteum means bone. Around the bone means periosteum. The periosteum consists of two layers. Superficial outer fibrous layer and deep cellular layer containing osteoblasts, which are the bone forming cells. And this periosteum is responsible for circumferential growth of the bone, growth of the bone in the diameter, growth of the bone in widths through the osteoblastic layer of the periosteum. In young age, while the bone is still growing, there is a plate of cartilage. There is a plate of cartilage called epiphyseal cartilage. Epiphyseal cartilage. And this epiphyseal cartilage is responsible for growth of bone vertically, longitudinally, growth in length. Therefore, growth of bone in the diameter, in the circumference, through the periosteum, which containing osteoblasts, which are the bone forming cells. And the growth of bone vertically through this cartilage, which is called the epiphyseal cartilage. This epiphyseal cartilage is formed of hyaline cartilage, like the articular cartilage, which is also hyaline cartilage. The epiphyseal cartilage separates the end of the bone, which is called epiphysis, and this area. What is this area? Just after the epiphysis and after the epiphyseal cartilage. After means meta. Therefore, this area after the epiphysis is called metaphysis. The epiphyseal cartilage or growth plate is the physis or epiphyseal cartilage or plate. Just above the physis is epiphysis, and just after the physis is metaphysis. Meta means after. This area, which is called the metaphysis, which is the area close to the epiphyseal cartilage, and it is the most active part of the bone. Why? Because the cells of the epiphyseal cartilage proliferate and start to ossify, and the newly formed bone migrate to the metaphysis. Later on, another new bone formation is formed from the epiphyseal cartilage, and the new bone formation migrate to the metaphysis and the bush. The previously formed bone downward to the center of the shaft, to the diaphysis. Therefore, the area of new bone formation from the epiphyseal cartilage present here in the metaphysis. This is the first type of bone according to shape, which is called long bone. In contrast to the long bone, what is the contrast to long? The contrast is short bones. There are two examples for the short bones. Short bones at the region of the wrist, which are called carpal bones. And the short bones in the foot, which are called tarsal bones. the carpal bone and the tarsal bones, and next we'll take flat bone. The carpal bone or flat bone or tarsal bone, short bone and flat bone, formed of layers, outer layers of compact bones, and in the center there is a spongy cancellous bone. Therefore, there is cancellous spongy bone covered by a layer of compact bone. This is a short bone. Next, we have flat bones. What are the flat bones? Flat bones, three examples. Skull, cap, vault of skull, the upper part of skull. This bone, which is called scapula, and the ribs. These are flat bones. The flat bone consists of what? Central layer of spongy bone and two layers of compact bone. In the skull, the two layers of compact bone are called outer and the inner table of the skull. If this the skull, outer table and the inner table, outer table towards the hair, your hair, towards the scalp, and the inner table is towards the brain, and in between the two tables there are cancellous spongy bone called debloy. The inner or middle layer of cancellous bone called debloy. What is the function of this flat bone? The skull, protection of the brain, and the skull or other flat bone for muscle attachment. After long bone, short bone, and flat bone, there are pneumatic bones. Pneumo means air. Pneumatic bones means bones containing air. Bones containing cavity, and the cavity full of air. These cavities and these bones surrounding the nose, like maxilla, containing cavity and containing sinus called maxillary air sinus. This maxilla containing one cavity. There are other bones containing multiple cavities, like this bone, which is called mastoid bone, containing many spaces containing air, called mastoid air cells. Why the paranasal sinuses and the bones surround the skull containing air? To decrease the weight of the skull, to allow resonance of voice, and all these cavities containing lined by mucous membrane rich in blood supply, and exposure of air to this mucosa, which containing high vascularity, will warm the air to avoid inspiration of cold air, which may damage the mucous membrane and damage the lung. To warm the inspired air, the entering air in the nose, pass in these cavities, leading to warmth of this inspired air. After pneumatic bones, there are irregular bones. Irregular bones, the bone, why irregular? Because there are many processes projecting from the bone. Therefore, the bone is irregular. And it has the same structure, like flat bone, like short bone, two layers of compact bone, and in between there is cancellous bone. After regular bones, there are sesamoid bones. Sesamoid bones are small nodules of bone embedded in tendons, like this bone, which is called the patella, embedded in the tendon of this muscle, which is the muscle of the front of the thigh, the famous muscle, which is called quadriceps femoris. What is the function of sesamoid bones? To limit and to decrease friction between the tendon and the underlying bone. The largest sesamoid bone in the body is this bone, which is called patella. Finally, there is sutural bones. What are sutural bones? Very, very small bones present in the sutures of the skull, called sutural bones. These are the types of bones according to the shape. Long, and the reverse is short. Fillet bone, pneumatic bone, sesamoid bone, sutural bones, irregular bones. After we know the types of bones, we need to know growth of bone, but this makes the video very long, therefore we will discuss growth of bone and the blood supply of the bone in the next video. Thank you for good listening and good luck.